Hello everyone. In this video, we'll see how to file GSTR-1 from Zoho Books. GSTR-1 is a monthly or quarterly return that contains the details of outward supplies made by registered taxpayers. The process of filing GSTR-1 involves three steps. Enable API access in your GSTN account, push your data from Zoho Books to the GSTN portal, finally submit and file your return. Zoho Books has introduced a GST filing approval feature where, after pushing the data to the GSTN portal, the users can submit the return for approval to the admins of the organization. And once approved, the return can be submitted to the GSTN portal and then filed. First, let's see how to enable the GST filing approval feature. Go to Settings and click on Taxes. Then, click on GST Settings. Check the box against GST filing approval, then choose the approvers. The admins of the organization will be listed. You can choose the approvers from among them. Then hit Save. The GST filing approval is now enabled in your organization. Now, the GSTR-1 cannot be submitted to the GSTN without the admin's approval. Next, let's see how to enable the API access. Zoho Books connects with your GSTN account through APIs. Therefore, the first step is to enable the API access and establish this connection. Log into the GSTN portal and click on My Profile. Then click on Manage API Access. Check Yes under Enable API Request. Then select the duration as per your preference and then click Confirm. You have successfully enabled the API access. Let's see how to push your data from Zoho Books to the GSTN portal. Log into Zoho Books and go to the GST filing module. Choose the month of filing the return from the drop-down. If you file your GSTR-1 quarterly, then select the last month of the quarter. As you can see, the GSTR-1 report is populated as per the format given in the GSTN portal. In the Overview tab, you can view the summary of the data, categorized and ordered based on the tables in the GSTR-1. You can click here to drill down and see the transactions, and you can filter the transactions using these filters. In the Push to GSTN tab, you can view all the transactions that are yet to be pushed to the GSTN portal. You can view and verify the transaction summary, the HSN, NIL, and the B2CS summary. Under the Documents Issued section, you can click on Edit and add the serial numbers of the transactions, the total number of documents issued, and the total number of cancelled documents under each document type. After verifying your data, you can click on the Push to GSTN button. Enter the aggregate turnover and click on Push to GSTN. An OTP will be sent to your registered mobile number and email address. Enter that OTP and click on Verify and Push. You'll receive an email as well as an in-app notification once your data is pushed to the GSTN portal. If there are any errors, you can navigate to the Failed Transactions tab, edit the corresponding transactions, and push them again. If you have enabled GST filing approval in your organization, once your data is successfully pushed to the GSTN portal, you need to submit the return for approval before submitting it to the GSTN. Click on Submit for Approval, then click on Yes. Once submitted for approval, the push option will be blocked and the status will change to pending approval. The approver can approve or reject it. If there are multiple approvers, then any one of them can approve the return. In case you have to make corrections in the return, but have submitted it for approval, as long as no action is done on the approval, you can recall it, make the necessary changes, and then submit it for approval again. Note, only the user who submitted the approval can recall it. If rejected, then the user will have to make the necessary changes and submit for approval again. And if it's approved, you can submit and file the return to the GSTN. You'll receive an in-app as well as an email notification for all of the above actions. Note, Once approved, the action cannot be reverted. Now, let's see how to submit and file the returns. Go to the File Your Return tab. A summary of the return will be fetched from the GSTN portal and populated here. Verify it and then click on Submit. This is a very important step because once you submit your data, you cannot make any changes to it. Type Submit in the text box. Read the acknowledgement and check the box. Then click on Proceed. Once your return is successfully submitted to the GSTN portal, you'll receive an in-app as well as an email notification. Then click on File Now. Enter the PAN that is associated with your GSTIN over here. Note: Zoho Books does not store or use any of the above details. These are transferred to the GSTN for filing purposes. Read the acknowledgement and check this box. And then click on Generate OTP. An OTP will be sent to your registered mobile number and email ID. Enter that OTP here. Click on File Now. You have now successfully filed your GSTR-1. You'll receive an email notification that the GSTR-1 has been filed. If you have any queries, you can write to us at support.india@zohobooks.com. Thank you.